nicht.
Ich habe mir gedacht, ich nenne ihn Bambi.
Bambi? Pinocchio.
Pinocchio. Dumbo. El Gran.
Tonight, the legacy of Walt Disney comes alive in Europe. Live from Paris, we celebrate the birth of a new Magic Kingdom. With the grand opening of Euro Disney.
Howdy, folks!
Herzlich willkommen!
The grand opening of Euro Disney. Starring Jose Carreras, Cher, Isabelle and Paul Duchesnay, Gloria Estefan and Miami Sound Machine, The Gypsy Kings, Angela Lansbury, The Four Tops, The Temptations, Tina Turner, and special correspondent Pat O'Brien. Plus appearances by the Disney characters known and loved throughout the world. The 650-piece All-American Marching Band and Drill Team. And the Euro Disney premiere of Michael Jackson's Magic Kingdom classic, Captain EO. And now, your host for the evening, Madame Melanie Griffith, and Monsieur Don Johnson.
Bonsoir.
Good evening and welcome to the grand opening of Euro Disney.
Tonight is a very special night. For nearly 40 years, anybody who lives here in Europe has had to go to America or Japan to visit a Magic Kingdom. But tonight, the Magic Kingdom finally comes to them, and only 20 miles from Paris.
For everybody who remembers what it was like waiting for the original Disneyland to open, tonight's going to bring back a lot of memories.
Over the next 2 hours, you'll see this entire place come to life. Starting in just a few minutes with the lighting of Le Château de la Belle au Bois Dormant.
Oh.
Sleeping Beauty's castle. Can't have a Magic Kingdom without a Magic Castle.
No. And throughout the evening, we'll be counting down to the spectacular grand opening ceremony.
But first, let's go on to Main Street, USA, to a guy we just recently met at the Olympics in Albertville, France. One of CBS Sports top anchors, Mr. Pat O'Brien. Pat.
All right, Don, Melanie, thank you. Good evening, everybody. First things first, five-year-old Sean Patrick O'Brien gave his thumbs up A-OK on the park. Disney likes it when the kids like the park, and that's out of the way. Secondly, back in France, and you recall that during the Olympics, at the end of each day, we announced our star of the day, l'étoile du jour. Well, back in France, and we still have a star theme tonight. The stars looking down upon us, and the stars making their debut ride of Main Street, USA. And an early twilight view of Disneyland Hotel and the ceremony. A lot of stars arriving early. There's Jean-Claude Van Damme. Jane Seymour and both her children were here all week for the festivities, and as was Michael J. Fox. What would an opening be really anywhere without Mickey and Minnie Mouse, who got out of a nicely tailored limo? And who's in the front seat? Donald Duck and Daisy, the crowd loving that. Peter Gabriel, the singer, was here. Some of the stars got their hands a little dirty at Disney World, including Candace Bergen, Murphy Brown, who was here, loving it all. Eddie Murphy and his entourage, including Mickey Mouse in his car, sat in the parade, ticker tape parade, Disney style, with the whole area, the whole world loving it. Stars, stars, and more stars, but I'm sure that by the end of the evening, you'll agree with my son that the l'étoile du jour of this place is the park itself. Back to Don and Melanie, a prince and a Cinderella.
Thanks, Pat. Pat will be checking in with stories throughout the evening, but right now, The lighting of Sleeping Beauty's castle is just moments away.
You know, this castle posed a real challenge for Euro Disney's creators. I mean, after all, how do you make a castle stand out in a country that prides itself on having some of the finest castles in the world? Well, the designers of Euro Disney decided to create a fantasy castle, one inspired by the illustrations in classic fairy tales.
And just as the Eiffel Tower has become the symbol of Paris, Le Château de la Belle au Bois Dormant will symbolize all the fantasy and magic that awaits visitors to Euro Disney. And since many of those visitors will be children, the castle lighting will feature a choir of children from all over Europe.
Mm. And now, selected from over 12,000 cast members to be the park's official spokesperson, here is Euro Disney's ambassador to the world, Sabine Marcon, to begin the ceremony.
Mesdames et messieurs, l'ambassadeur d'Euro Disney à travers le monde, Sabine Marcon.
Au nom de toute l'équipe d'Euro Disney qui vient de l'Europe entière, bienvenue. Bienvenue à nos invités ici présents et à vous qui nous regardez dans le monde entier. Et maintenant, je suis très heureuse de vous présenter le président de la Walt Disney Company, Monsieur Michael Eisner.
Thank you, Sabine, and thank you, everyone. The founder of our company once said, "What I want more than anything else is for Disneyland to be a place where grown-ups and children can experience together the wonders of life, of adventure, and come out feeling the better for it." Well, Walt's dream is also our dream for Euro Disney. And so, with young voices from all over Europe, we dedicate Le Château de la Belle au Bois Dormant to both the young and the young at heart. To those who believe when you wish upon a star, your dreams do come true. Thank you.
Party begins.
First stop is Euro Disney's Land of the Future, Discoveryland. And on stage at its high-tech rock club, Videopolis, one of Europe's favorite American performers, Cher.
Oh, no! Mickey and Cher. That's got a nice ring to it, don't you think?
Yeah, it does, you know, but I guess Minnie wouldn't be too crazy about them going on the road together.
No, probably not.
The grand opening of Euro Disney will continue with Olympic ice dancing medal winners Isabel and Paul Duchesnay, Gloria Estefan, and the Gypsy Kings. Over the past week, people from all over the world have flown to Paris to be a part of tonight's historic event, the grand opening of Euro Disney. The grand opening of Euro Disney, sponsored by McDonald's. What you want is what you get at McDonald's today. And by JCPenney, now proudly celebrating their 90th anniversary.
Savings throughout the store.
Ask anyone who's driven a Ford lately. Like the people from Car and Driver, who've named Taurus SHO one of their 10 best. The people from Motor Trend, who named Explorer the best buy in its class. Or any one of the thousands of people who've made Escort the best-selling small car in America. Have you driven a Ford lately? It's more than just a question. It's an answer.
And I milk chocolate with a fresh roasted peanut inside.
And we're both covered in a thin candy shell. Let's go!
The milk chocolate melts in your mouth, not in your hand.
Worldwide sponsor of the 1992 Olympic Games.
Sharon Gless and Robert Wagner together.
What is this town really all about?
In an affair gone wild.
I've fallen in love with a stranger.
Gone reckless.
Oh, my God.
Gone out of control.
What do you want from me?
More.
Will he change her life forever?
I love you, Rosie O'Neill.
Rosie's back and she's in love. Next.
It is challenging. It is breathtaking. It is a tradition unlike any other. The Masters on CBS.
Debbie Thomas and Katarina Vith renew their legendary rivalry, plus Olympic gold medalist Victor Petrenko, the Diet Coke Skaters Championships, tomorrow.
If you have a problem with drug or alcohol abuse, help is as close as your telephone. A call to a local hotline will put you in touch with people who understand and care. Don't suffer alone.
Welcome back to the grand opening of Euro Disney, coming to you from La Ville des Lumières, the City of Lights, Paris, France.
You know, we think of Disney characters as being as American as apple pie. But actually, they're citizens of the world, known and loved in every corner of the globe.
From the moment Mickey took his steamboat across the Atlantic in 1929, Europe has had a love affair with Disney.
Tu veux un bonbon? Tu dois lire tout ce qui est écrit.
Je t'aime d'amour.
Et lis celui-là.
Embrasse-moi. But Mickey wasn't the first Disney character to appear in Europe. Disney roots go way back.
This is a very sentimental place for me, because the roots of my family come right back here to this village of Isigny-sur-Mer. It was over 900 years ago that Hugues d'Isigny and his son Robert lived here.
A few centuries later, during World War I, a teenage Walt Disney would serve in the land of his ancestors as an ambulance driver for the Red Cross. In his spare time, he drew cartoons for his fellow drivers. He got 10 francs a drawing. The first real money he ever made as an artist. Before long, he'd be drawing a certain mouse. And by the early 30s, that mouse was the world's biggest star.
And in 1935, the League of Nations proclaimed Mickey an international symbol of goodwill. Not bad for a seven-year-old. Walt himself came to Europe to accept the award. But it wasn't the award that made the trip special. While in Paris, Walt visited a theater that was showing nothing but Disney cartoons back to back all day long. Walt had been told that audiences would never pay to see cartoons alone.
Qui craint le grand méchant loup, méchant loup, grand loup noir? Qui craint le grand méchant loup?
Yet the French were doing just that.
The reaction of Paris to the show convinced Walt to go full speed ahead with the biggest gamble of his career. The world's first feature-length cartoon. Not only did Europe give Walt the confidence to make the film, it also gave him the story. And 3 years later, the world was treated to a masterpiece.
Snow White was only the first of many Disney classic films based on the stories and legends of Europe.
Right now, it's time to hear from another group of performers who, like Mickey Mouse, have become international symbols of goodwill, who transcend the barriers of language through music.
And the music of these guys has taken them from the gypsy caravans of southern France to CD players around the world. At the castle stage, here are the Gypsy Kings!
All right.
Siempre la recuerdo. Cada vez que se vuelve a darme, quisiera nunca va de tristeza el corazón. Por mí nunca va de ser alma. Y dámela. Esta niña que yo quiero, dámela. Esta niña que me muero.
Talk about music for the soul.
Straight from the heart.
Are you having a good time?
I'm having a great time, the best. Mickey throws one heck of a party, don't you think?
He sure does. Well, right now, let's go back to Pat O'Brien for the lowdown on Countdown to Zero Hour. Pat.
All right, Don, thank you. We're down here right in front of Sleeping Beauty's castle, and the people who built and planned Euro Disney have been building and planning for years and months and days, and now They're down to minutes, 94 minutes and counting until the opening of Euro Disney. We'll be here counting with you.
Right now, let's go back in time. In the late 1840s, America was swept up by the news that gold had been found in California. Before long, the entire world caught gold rush fever.
And here in France, they held the lottery of the golden ingots, the grand prize, a free trip to California's gold country.
And by the 1850s, over 30,000 men and women from all over Europe had gone west to seek their fortune. The glory of those gold rush days has been recreated in Euro Disney's Frontierland. Just beyond Frontierland's gates lies Thunder Mesa, a mining town with everything from a saloon to a haunted mansion, just like the towns that sprung up overnight during America's pioneer days. The only difference is that this one came to life today. There you have it, the Wild West Disney style.
I love the Phantom Manor. It's the best Disney haunted house yet.
Yeah, it made me kind of homesick for the kids.
Oh, stop it.
Just kidding. Right now, let's go across the park to one of the six hotels here at Euro Disney.
Standing by at the ice rink of the New York Hotel is Mickey Mouse with a little magic.
I'd like to introduce one of the greatest names in ice skating.
Donald Duck!
Huh?
Thanks, Mickey.
Donald,
please. Thanks, Johnny Money.
But Donald, now, don't get angry. Well, you see, the skaters are humans.
What? Humans? What's the big idea?
And now...
<I'm Donald.
laughs> Sorry, Donald. And now... I give you the real skaters, the Olympic silver medal winners, the Duchesnes.
Wow.
Wow.
Wouldn't you like to do that just once?
Oh, my God. No wonder they're national heroes here in France. They're magnificent, aren't they?
Magnifique.
Oui. Right now, here's a shot from our blimp showing all the lands of Euro Disney still to visit tonight. Fantasyland, Adventureland, and the new land that you won't find anywhere else, Discoveryland.
Now, here's a fun way to get around the park, or around the house for that matter. The Euro Disney Railroad.
This is the George Washington, one of three steam locomotives built in Wales, especially for Euro Disney.
We'll be right back with Gloria Estefan, The Temptations, The Four Tops, and Jose Carreras.
Center of Main Street, ready for the official opening ceremony. And now, Walt Disney will step forward to read the dedication of Disneyland.
To all who come to this happy place, welcome. Disneyland is your land. Here age relives fond memories of the past. And here youth may savor the challenge and promise of the future. Disneyland is dedicated to the ideals, the dreams, and the hard facts that have created America, with the hope that it will be a source of joy and inspiration to all the world. Thank you.
Why should you change phone companies when you're perfectly happy with the one you've got?
Sprint spokesperson. Volume discounts. So if you call a lot, it would be nuts to use anyone else. You have relatives in over 180 countries. Sprint lets you call them all direct. Phone cards, even in Braille. Sprint and go down and leave a kabillion people stranded. Call now and you'll even get 100 minutes free. How many more reasons do you need?
Just released on video, 101 Dalmatians.
The puppies were everywhere.
The Disney movie you've waited for is coming to your home.
Cash?
You know, the thing is, with that card, I don't know where. That's the problem.
Looking for cash without MasterCard isn't exactly easy.
And there's a corset store there. Now you go through that corset store, they don't mind.
But with MasterCard, you can get cash just about anywhere. At nearly 200,000 bank branches and 60,000 ATMs. So count on MasterCard and master the moment.
Dirt road.
Be back real soon.
Finally got my first break.
I got a singing spot for you starting next week.
Then he asked for more than I wanted to give.
I am not a whore!
And I had to put the man in his place.
Stop playing with me.
And when I start playing with you, you're never gonna want me to stop.
Vanessa Williams, Michael Warren, stomping at the Savoy Sunday.
Monday, Bert shares the naked truth.
Look friendly.
On Evening Shade. Then it's Tabloid Mania on Murphy Brown.
I was Murphy Brown's boy, toy.
Golden. Before Murphy, it's a special all-new Brooklyn Bridge, where even your biggest kid won't grow up.
32 to 4, we're making a comeback.
Okay, so it's Evening Shade and all-new Brooklyn Bridge and Murphy Brown Monday.
This is CBS.
We're here in Underground Atlanta for the Pick and Pay Challenge to see if everyday shoe buyers can tell the difference between the Pick and Pay shoe and the higher-priced brand-name competitor.
I picked this one.
That one?
Yes.
Do you know what?
What?
You picked the Pick and Pay shoe.
Oh, I did.
Do you know you picked the Pick and Pay shoe?
You're kidding.
For under $10, you can get that shoe.
$10?
Mm-hmm.
$10?
These shoppers can't tell the difference, and you won't be able to either. Take the Pick and Pay Challenge.
In Greensboro, North Carolina, a remodeled kitchen turned into the McLaren's new family room. In Norfolk, Virginia, a new minivan made the halls a little more popular with their friends. And in Washington, D.C., an additional room allowed Mark Gonzalez to put his father in the best possible home, his own. Nation's bank loan specialists have helped over 2 million people with loans for home improvements, loan refinancing, and car loans. Come see how Nation's Bank can give you the power to make a difference in your life.
Chris Clackham and Sarah Van Allen, Charlotte's most popular weekend news.
Welcome back to the grand opening of Euro Disney. And the countdown to the spectacular grand opening ceremony continues. You know, when I was a kid, one of my greatest dreams was to go to California and Disneyland. And you can bet a lot of kids here in Europe are doing the same thing with Euro Disney.
You know, a lot of grown-ups are, too. I mean, this is a big event here. After all, it's only the fourth time in history that a Magic Kingdom has come to life. And tonight's grand opening is being broadcast live on 5 different networks to more than 60 million Europeans in 5 languages. I mean, that's big.
Wow. Yeah. Here's Pat O'Brien now with more on the international flavor of this event.
Actually, Donna Melody, it's quite an attraction down here at the Hub. People watching other people, putting them on live television. You can see 2 of the 5 countries here broadcasting live all over Europe, Spain, and Great Britain right there, uniting the world under the name of Disney. Here's what it looked like back behind the scenes.
Y además constituye la primera película de dibujos animados que ha sido nominada para un Oscar de Hollywood.
Der Kollege aus Amerika, Seton Johnson, hat Melanie Griffith mitgemacht. Meine Frau muss auf die Kinder aufpassen.
Thank you,
Rodrigo. Thank you. Oh, das ist aber important.
E tutto il parco sarà poi collegato alla rete ferroviaria del TGV, il velocissimo treno francese. Poi 2 anni dopo, ecco, questo è il treno.
Stand by to take the US feed. And US feed.
And for you kids watching at home, please do not try this in the safety of your own home. You know, you come to an international area and you expect international cuisine, international flavor, as we say. What do they give us? Hamburger and French fries. It's like home.
Thank you, Pat. In the early 1980s, a new sound in music emerged from the streets of Miami, an exciting blend of Latin, pop, rock, and disco. And it caught on here in Europe even before the States got hip to it.
Today, the music of Gloria Estefan and the Miami Sound Machine is a sound loved around the world. And they've got 13 international gold and platinum albums to prove it. Here are some old pals of mine from the streets of Miami. Gloria Estefan and the Miami Sound Machine.
Just need you here with me. Maybe I live for love.
the biz, they call that a great hook. You know, in the months leading up to today, people here in France and all over Europe have been asking, qu'est-ce que c'est Euro Disney?
What is Euro Disney?
Very good. Well, for one thing, it's big.
Euro Disney covers over 5,000 acres, an area one-fifth the size of Paris. Other than the Channel Tunnel, which will connect England and France, it is the largest construction project in Europe's history.
Since the groundbreaking in 1988, over 10,000 men and women have helped build the park. And now that the park is finished, over 11 million visitors are expected this year alone.
And to make them feel at home, all 12,000 members of Euro Disney staff can speak at least two languages. Some are fluent in as many as five.
Like Walt Disney World, Euro Disney has so many things to see and do that you shouldn't expect to see it all in one day. So Disney commissioned some of the world's leading architects to build six hotels just outside the Magic Kingdom, all designed to make guests feel like they're visiting America, from the East Coast to the West.
For those who prefer roughing it, there's even a campground.
And for the first time at any Disney theme park, a hotel has been built right at the entrance to the park. And earlier today, the Disneyland Hotel was dedicated with a spectacular ceremony.
Check out Main Street for a moment. These are the Keystone Cops, a quintet of gendarmes unlike any you'll see along the Champs-Élysées.
The grand opening of Euro Disney will return with the Temptations, the Four Tops, the opening of Fantasyland, and Michael Jackson as Captain EO.
Disney from Paris, France.
Oui, oui. You know that land in fairy tales is always far, far away?
Mm-hmm.
Well, this is it, Europe, the place where many of the best-loved Disney characters had their start.
Aha! From Germany came Snow White, Italy gave us Pinocchio, England Peter Pan and Alice in Wonderland, and France brought us Cinderella and Sleeping Beauty.
But, you know, it was Walt Disney who took them around the world.
Salagadou, la menchikabou, la bibidi-bobidi-bou. Mélangez tout ça et vous aurez quoi? Bibidi-bobidi-bou. Salagadou, la menchikabou, la bibidi-bobidi-bou. C'est de la magie ou je ne m'y connais pas. Bibidi-bobidi-bou. Salagadoula veut dire la menchikaskou bidou. Mais le truc qui fait boum à tous les coups, c'est bibidi-bobidi-bou. Mélangez tout ça et vous aurez quoi?
Mmh.
like a boat out of the blue. Fate steps in and sees you through. One wish upon a star, your dreams come.
No matter what language you speak, when you think of Pinocchio, Snow White, or Cinderella, what you probably see in your mind are these Disney images. And in Euro Disney's Fantasyland, these wonderful characters and stories come to life.
This world of make-believe was officially opened earlier this week with one of the most memorable scenes in any fairy tale, the awakening of Sleeping Beauty.
Standing here with Natalie Lewis, who works both at the Orlando Park, and she's here helping out at Euro Disney. And good evening to you, Natalie. How does this park differ from the ones back in the States?
It's very different. This park is adapted for Europe. All the attractions you can see are very, very similar to the ones we have in Florida, but they yet much different. Like pirates are much more European than in our park.
Natalie is from France, and if someone plopped you down in this park, would you realize that you were in your home country?
No. Actually, when you leave the park and you realize you're in France, it's a big shock. But if you're in this park, there's no way of telling that you're in France. All the cast members speak different languages, so you don't even know if a cast member is French or British or Dutch or whatever.
So, it's got a great feeling, doesn't it?
Yes, it's very neat. It's very neat.
Natalie, thank you.
Thank you.
When the Beatles invaded the U.S. in 64, America countered by sending the Temptations and the Four Tops to Europe. Over the past 28 years, they've come back again and again, always a smash. But in all that time, the two groups have never performed together here. Never, that is, until this visit to Euro Disney. From the Castle Stage, here are the Temptations and the Four Tops.
need your loving. Got to have all your loving. Baby, I need your loving. Got to have all your loving.
Wait a minute, wait a minute. I can turn the gray sky blue.
I can make it rain, hey, whenever I want it to.
And the amazing thing is that they had their first rehearsal as a group only 2 days ago.
Great.
Now we're going back to Frontierland, and those are the mariachis.
They've come all the way from Mexico to be here at Euro Disney.
We'll be back with Tina Turner, opera great Jose Carreras, and a visit to Buffalo Bill's Wild West show.
Be back real soon.
Welcome back. You know, for over a century, Paris has been famous for its nightlife. Long before Frank Sinatra or Liza Minnelli ever sang the praises of New York, New York, Paris was the original city that never sleeps.
And last night, Euro Disney spectacularly lit up the City of Lights with its own addition to Parisian life in the Fast Lane. Festival Disney.
Festival Disney brings to Paris a taste of American entertainment, dining, and nightlife. From the delicatessens of New York to the discos of Key West.
Looks like one of my old stomping grounds. Now, one of the main attractions is Buffalo Bill's Wild West show. The show toured the world for over 30 years, and it became the toast of Paris in 1889. Only this time, the Buffalo came by 747. And now they're bilingual. The stars are out tonight as we count down only 46 minutes now to the exciting grand opening of Euro Disney. Standing here with Candace Bergen, earlier in the show we saw you putting your hand in cement. Did you wash your hands yet? Are you okay? You enjoying the park? It's beautiful, isn't it?
Oh, it's fabulous. It's fabulous. I love it as much as my daughter does, I think. I don't know who's having a better time.
What does she like the best, you know, or just the whole thing?
Well, I think she loved when I broke the target last night at the Wild West show and I shot at it. And she loves Thunder Mountain, which we've been on 8 times.
Right.
And I'm finally getting tired of Thunder Mountain. I never thought it would happen. And we love the dragon in here, and we love all of it. But I think for me, the surprise was the Wild West show. Yeah. To come all the way to outside of Paris to see 15 buffalo and Indians and cowboys from
go to South Dakota to see that.
Well, I mean, you know, it was easier than taking her around America to see all of that, so it's been great.
What would Murphy Brown say about this?
Oh, well, Murphy would be backstage wondering how ever they got these French to be this polite.
A straight shooter, Candace Bergen. Thank you.
Thank you.
About 40 years ago, a mother in Barcelona took her young son to the movies. And after seeing the film, the boy knew exactly what he wanted to be when he grew up. The movie was The Great Caruso, starring Mario Lanza, and the boy went on to become one of the world's greatest tenors. A favorite around the world.
He's here with us tonight, Mr. Jose Carreras.
Coming up, Angela Lansbury and Disney's most romantic moments. There have been a lot of them, folks. And now, as all evening, here in the Magic Kingdom, there is music everywhere.
And this is Frontierland. Inside this stockade, Walt Disney has created a frontier village that could have been carved out of the wilderness 100 years ago by the pioneers. The flag, flying over the stockade, has 13 stars commemorating America's first period of independence.
Welcome back. One of the biggest surprises coming here this week has been seeing the differences between Euro Disney, Disneyland, and Walt Disney World.
Take Adventureland. Here at Euro Disney, the jungles of Anaheim and Orlando have been replaced by the desert sands of Morocco.
But all the Adventurelands do share some things in common, things like mystery, intrigue, and pirates. I think that's my all-time favorite Disney ride.
You know, the original in California was the last ride that Walt Disney personally supervised.
Really?
Hey, Pat's not the only one who's done a little research.
I am very impressed, honey. You know, Disney has not only provided us with some of the funniest moments that we've ever seen, but also some of the most romantic.
Yeah. Yes, many of our first ideas about love and romance were formed by Disney films like Cinderella and Sleeping Beauty. Of course, as we grow up, we learn that real life doesn't always guarantee a Prince Charming or a happy ending.
Well, and yet, no matter how much older or wiser we do get, these films never lose their magic for us. We still believe.
Last December, Disney premiered a love story based on a classic French fairy tale. A story for today, yet a tale as old as time. Beauty and the Beast.
And here to sing the Academy Award-winning title song is one of my all-time favorites, Angela Lansbury.
Tale as old as time, true as it can be, barely even friends, then somebody bends unexpectedly. Just a little change, small to say the least, both a little scared, neither one prepared. Beauty and the Beast. Ever just the same. Ever a surprise. Ever as before. Ever just as sure as the sun will rise. Tale as old as time. Tune as old as song. Bittersweet and strange, finding you can change, learning you were wrong. Certain as the sun, rising in the east. Tale as old as time, song as old as rhyme. Beauty and the Beast. Tale as old as time, song as old as rhyme, Beauty and the Beast. Off to the cupboard with you now, Chip. It's past your bedtime.
cannot love.
Remember the first time you saw a Disney romance?
Absolutely. It was Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. You know, to tell you the truth, though, I wanted Snow White to be a blonde.
Well, you lucked out with Cinderella and Sleeping Beauty.
And with Lady, too.
Lady?
As in Lady and the Tramp.
Melanie, she was a redhead.
Yeah, after she came to Hollywood.
Ah. Bat.
Out here in the middle of the park, I'm Pat O'Brien. Kids of all ages, including myself, are staying up late for the opening of Euro Disney, and they're all anticipating even this one. You having a good time tonight?
Yes, very good time.
A lot of smiles. A couple of them a little tired, but I think they'll stay up for the opening. We've got a nice smile here. Look at that. We'll be here. We're waiting for it to open.
We'll be right back with Tina Turner, the opening of Discoveryland, and Michael Jackson as Captain EO. In a moment.
I'm Charles Carroll. What's the future of federal funding for the arts? A controversy.
When the author Jules Verne was 11 years old, he ran away from home to become a cabin boy on a ship bound for the West Indies. Even then, he loved adventure. But moments before his boat was to sail, his father bound him and dragged him home. After he was scolded and punished, young Jules made his family and himself a promise. From now on, he said, I'll travel only in my imagination.
Yeah, but what a way to go.
Through his imagination, Jules Verne went to the North Pole, the moon, and 20,000 leagues under the sea. And the best part is that he took the whole world with him.
Tonight, he returns to France to open the newest land of all, Discoveryland. The land Euro Disney devoted to one of his favorite destinations, the future.
Bonsoir. Le monde de Discoveryland retrace la quête de l'humanité pour parvenir à concrétiser les espoirs et les rêves de ces hommes de tous les temps qui furent et sont les inventeurs du futur. Ici, on peut constater qu'imagination rime avec innovation. Aussi, j'ai le plaisir d'ouvrir Discoveryland par ce dicton qui, depuis toujours, a été le mien. Ce que l'homme peut concevoir, l'homme peut l'accomplir. D'aucuns m'en attribuent la paternité. Ah, en fait, il y a toujours eu des rêveurs qui ont essayé d'imaginer de quoi demain sera fait. Ce sont nos idées, nos prédictions, si vous préférez, qui ont permis de créer Discoveryland, le monde de demain, tel que nous, les visionnaires, aurions pu l'imaginer. Et il faut ajouter, bien sûr, que les visionnaires ont l'imagination particulièrement fertile. Vous avez de nos jours la possibilité de voyager au-delà de la planète Terre, de voyager vers les astres, il y a un siècle, j'ai entraîné mes lecteurs en voyage vers la Lune. Et en 1902, Georges Méliès, vous savez, le cinéaste, a adapté mon histoire pour le grand écran dans son film Le Voyage dans la Lune. Vous ne pouvez pas imaginer le plaisir que ça m'a fait de le voir. Oh, mais si vous le pouvez, j'en suis sûr.
Mesdames et messieurs, Star Tours vous invite à embarquer à bord de l'Andorre Express, le service de Star Speeder non-stop à destination de la Lune d'Andorre. Préparez-vous à l'embarquement.
Star Tours announces the boarding of the Endor Express, non-stop Star Speeder service to the moon of Endor. All passengers, please prepare for immediate boarding.
Et plus près de vous, un autre Georges, un cinéaste aussi, George Lucas, a créé pour Discoveryland Star Tours. Un voyage dans l'espace d'un réalisme saisissant. D'après son chef-d'œuvre, La Guerre des Étoiles.
Monsieur Byrne, your flight is boarding.
Oh, merci. Venez.
Lightspeed to Endor!
Brick 24, I'm going in. Cover me.
Magnifique! Oh. Oh, vous savez, ce qui m'étonne le plus à Discoveryland, c'est que nous, les visionnaires, ayons pu voir tout ça. L'automobile, l'aéroplane, la télévision, les voyages dans l'espace. Ah. Il y a cependant, à Discoveryland, un phénomène qu'aucun d'entre nous n'avait prévu. Michael Jackson.
The excitement is building.
You know, they're going to have fireworks going off from 10 different locations here.
No kidding.
That's right.
I can't wait.
Right now, though, we have to go back to Adventureland and the African Tam Tam, an authentic African percussion group that has come all the way from Zaire to be here at Euro Disney.
Looks like a good place to get away from all the noise out there. My friend Cipriano again. We're talking about baseball. You like baseball, huh?
Yes.
Yeah. What are your favorite teams in America?
I like Dodgers.
The Dodgers? Could be good this year. They have Daryl Strawberry and Eric Davis. Who else do you like?
And White Sox.
Chicago White Sox. Well, it's kind of noisy in here. Let's get out of here.
Okay.
You know, for most of us, a quarter of a century from now seems a long way off. But for the Imagineers of Euro Disney, the year 2017 is as close as tomorrow. This is the model shop at Walt Disney Imagineering, where every detail of Euro Disney has been built to scale, and where plans for the next 25 years of Euro Disney are already being made. For as Walt Disney himself once said, Disneyland will never be finished as long as there are people with imagination, with new dreams and new projects somewhere in the world.
under the sea.
In 1994, Euro Disney visitors will take a ride under the sea with the Little Mermaid.
Be our guest.
Beauty and the Beast will invite everyone to be their guest in Fantasyland. And the entire park will be linked to Europe by France's high-speed TGV railway system.
2 years later, Discovery Mountain, a ride Jules Verne might have designed, will become part of Discoveryland. And before this year ends, the ground will be broken for a second theme park, the Disney MGM Studios Europe, a working motion picture and TV production facility that will give visitors the opportunity to experience the world of movie making and the golden age of Hollywood. Opening date, 1995.
And there are other plans. Plans for rides, shows, and innovations that won't see the light of day until today's children come here with their children. And so tonight is not only the beginning of Euro Disney, but the start of many dreams to come.
2 years ago, after her record-breaking concert tour here in Europe, Tina Turner announced she was giving up performing for at least a year, and actually, it's been longer.
But the hardest working woman in rock and roll is back in action tonight. And she's here. Let's go to Videopolis and Tina Turner.
Yo!
Well, we're just moments away now from the opening ceremony. The Main Street Electrical Parade is underway.
And the All-American Marching Band is marching to the Central Plaza, where people from all over the park are arriving now for the event we've all been waiting for.
For the complete story, let's go to Pat O'Brien. Pat.
All right, Donna, Melody, on that side of the camera, thousands of people ready to come into Euro Disneyland. On this side of the camera, all the characters and the band members and the trumpets and the drums, you can hear them now, getting ready to receive them. The excitement is here because this is not just any opening. It's not just a building. It's not a department store. They're opening a magical kingdom here, and we're all invited. When we come back, the incredible opening of Euro Disneyland. Stay with us.
Thousands have gathered here at the center of the Magic Kingdom for the historic opening of Euro Disney. We are about to witness an event that will be remembered for many years to come.
With this ceremony, Euro Disney will join Disneyland, Walt Disney World, and Tokyo Disneyland as one of the few places on Earth where the world of imagination becomes real, where it can be touched and experienced.
Here we go.
The moment has arrived to welcome the world to Euro Disney, and here to make that welcome is the vice chairman of the Walt Disney Company and the son of one of our founders, Mr. Roy Disney.
Thank you, Michael, and thank you, everyone. I'd like to dedicate Euro Disney by using the words of a remarkable man, my uncle Walt Disney. He said them on the day one of his fondest dreams came true. To all who come to this happy place, welcome. This is your land. Here age relives fond memories of the past, and here youth may savor the challenge and promise of the future. We hope that it will be a source of joy and inspiration to the world. Now I'd like to ask Michael and Bob Fitzpatrick, the president of Euro Disney, to join me as we cut the ribbon that will officially open the park.
Et maintenant, je déclare Euro Disney officiellement ouvert.
Pat, what do you think of that? Don and Melanie, I've been to some of the biggest sporting events in the world, but this one, I think, is going to last forever. Me, I'm going to come back someday. Thanks for having me here.
Thanks for helping out, buddy.
Thank you, Pat.
Of course.
You got it. And to everybody on our American and international production team, merci, gracias, danke, grazie, thank you.
And thanks to all of you for watching. Good night.
Good night.
Delta can now fly you to more cities across the Atlantic than any other U.S. airline. At Delta,
New York, 1939. They were four young women who wanted it all, but each had to get there on her own. Emmy winner Lynn Whitfield, Vanessa Williams, and Jasmine Guy star in Stompin' at the Savoy, a world premiere movie tomorrow on CBS.